grunge became a noun, it seemed a way to pigeonhole a bunch of bands.
Along the way, somebody decided to call it grunge.
What is grunge? Does it involve a flannel shirt?
Welcome to the Nightbird. Caw-caw, caw-caw. I'm Joseph Rose.
And I am Jeremy Jerry Wood.
Guys, welcome to the show. This is a very special Nightbird edition of The Grunge, a show where we explore the catalogs of the big four of the Seattle sound, Jerry. But really, we hardly even fucking do that.
Not, no.
You know?
We don't know.
We might as well say, guys, we are a toaster repair podcast because we're going to talk about repairing toasters as regularly and with as much legitimate information as we will any of the bands that we're supposed to talk about. Okay.
Yeah, that would be it. The toaster repair podcast.
That's with almost what we are.
Copyright music playing on there, so we can't monetize anything.
That's right.
It's part of our thing. I didn't even think about it. Do we do that anymore?
I guess we're going to talk. We got a lot to talk about, guys.
Somebody will say something.
This is a very special Nightbird edition. I'm sure many of you are familiar, but if we have some new listeners that have hopped on, you are in for a treat, everyone. Mm-hmm. All right?
This is the cap off of 1993.
Well, no, Jerry.
Step forward into 1994.
Right. This is the beginning.
This is the beginning of another year.
Yeah. You know, our podcast moves in chronological order. We started in the late 80s. We're making our way through the 90s. And the records that we listen to, we do so in chronological order. And then when we complete a year, like we just have with 1993, we move into a new year, starting off with a curated playlist of songs from that year. Have I explained it properly?
I think you have. It's not what we're named after. It's everything around it.
Right.
And some of what you're...
Some of it is grunge.
But this is just a nice little introduction to the surrounding area of the grunge era.
Yes.
And I like this. This is one of the...
Don't get too excited.
This is one of the things I look forward to. And we didn't know it would be like a thing. We did a thing called Nightbird a while back. I drank heavily through it. It was my favorite broadcast I've ever done on this show.
That's a lie.
Yeah. You know, at the time it felt great.
Right.
Listening back to it was just a bunch of like moans and clicks, you know, yeah. From on my end at least. And then we did a second one.
I'm feeling like your tone is so aggressive and loud right now.
Well, we start them off like this every time. You know that. We've done three of these, and you've always said your voice is way aggressive.
I guess it's worth mentioning that Jerry did ruin this version of the Nightbird because he didn't want to do mushrooms and blah, blah, blah. He didn't want to do it. And as you guys know, that the last Nightbird episode was maybe the greatest thing ever. And we felt great doing it because Jerry did acquiesce to
a demand.
My request for mushrooms.
A demand.
And he loved it, and we both loved it, and all of you guys loved it as well.
We start off.
But tonight,
simpatico.
No such luck.
We start off so when we're just talking without these mics on, we get along so well. And then I'm confronted with something I didn't do. Yeah, wait, I thought it was a big hit. We're still doing this, though, and I think both of us are on the cannabis tonight.
Yes, I sure am.
Oh, yeah, you've not stopped.
I sure am, Jerry.
You're making up for something.
I'm just getting started.
Well,
this is but the tip, as they say, of the weed iceberg.
Mm-hmm.
The weedberg, if you will, Jerry.
Klaus Weedberg. But, yeah, you have the more XPN voice. I can see why my tenor would be a little bit more stabbing.
Just a little aggressive. Mm-hmm. Just try to chill you out. Think of the children, all right?
Oh, yeah, we do market to them. I put my bird on wrong, man. I put the bird. Right. The bird is now flapping away from you. I bought these birds for these stuffed birds for this very occasion, And I affixed mine wrong on my mic stand, if you have the video aspect of this, because this is the only part you'll ever see, because everything else will be blocked.
Oh, speaking of dead animals.
Tell me.
My friend. I have a friend. And she is gifting me two sweet fucking skulls of dead animals.
Okay.
I have a small collection of these skulls. Mm-hmm. And she is giving me two serious fucking skulls.
Well, you're a doctor of sorts, right?
I am a bit of a doctor.
So this is more for biological
research. These will be the largest skulls that I have in my collection.
Is she giving you, a moose, a deer?
I'm not telling you anything.
No, I don't. Well,
but
way to be defensive about legit. Your animal skulls.
They are legit.
Sounds like she's giving you bald
eagle. She cleaned these skulls herself.
Oh, good.
She prepared them.
Excellent.
And I'm so happy about it.
Where did she do
Darcelle, thank you.
Yes.
Thank you. If you're out there.
Thank you so much, Darcelle, for Remnants of a Body.
I appreciate it very much. So generous of her. I love this.
Oh, yeah. I'm
so excited about it.
I couldn't boil a skull. I mean, I just...
No, I don't believe they were boiled. It's not so great to boil them.
Oh. Interesting that we have a frame of reference here, boiling skulls. I've never done one. I just assume you boil everything off.
I have boiled one or two.
Okay.
It's not so good.
No? It's what you see in when people have headhunters in movies, you know? Yeah. They have them boiling off whatever, you know, to display it. I don't know what they did with the skulls at the end.
Jerry, I've now consumed a significant amount of cannabis.
It's supposed to be about an ounce.
I don't know about that.
We're all going to be very tired in the middle of the night, bird.
I do have an edible waiting for me over here. I'm going to give it a little bit
virtual cavalcade. Absolute. Yes, it is. An absolute avalanche of THC. Yes. I did smoke my one bowl in a traditional fashion. And then he goes in like, oh, I can't let that
Saturday happen. Night cannabis cavalcade coming at ya.
Tonight, a rodeo clown will be involved.
Jerry, God damn it, son. Don't get me excited on the Nightbird.
Oh, yeah, let's not have any
Nightbird, bro. Nightbird. Come on, man.
So we are now.
You've got a wild, shiny, boot this shoe. What are you wearing?
I had to go into work, so I didn't want to put on the uniform, but I had to look presentable. So
let me talk to you about your clothes, Jerry.
What's wrong with what I'm wearing today? It's nice.
Well, it's not about what you're wearing today. You're very nice. Blue today, and it's nice.
It's a blue.
You're very good. Your pants match your shirt. It's like you're just a one-colored blue thing.
Yep, I'm blue.
Now, I am sometimes concerned with how large your pants are.
Well, these aren't large. These aren't large.
Why are you so aggressive?
I'm saying these aren't.
Is my tone aggressive toward you?
I am aware of the size of my pants. Why so defensive? I lost that weight. I'm not trying to buy new clothes. I'll get to that.
I'll get you some pants.
I don't
what
need
size
pants
do you wear?
I'm at 32 now. 32-30.
Really?
They have a weird pant size.
32. Is that what I wear? Maybe. Or maybe I like a 32-32. Well, I don't remember.
We're both losing weight at the same time. Like, we were 158 last time we checked. Then I had a pizza, but now I'm back to 159. Like, I just went ballistic on some carbs.
I've gone ballistic today, actually. I've eaten every meal today and then some.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm not done yet.
I 3 days I've been trying not to. You're not done yet.
I'm not done yet. I got some Almond Joy right over here. I've got this delicious. What have we got here? This Zambia Bing Cherry Bai drink.
Mm-hmm.
You better turn that phone off or I will literally murder you on this thing.
I gotta see what that was about. Yeah. Who's talking to me?
Oh, speaking of which, right before the show, guys, a little inside fun here. Jerry did confide in me that he recently may have actually had sex.
Yes.
Is this right, Jerry?
I did do that. And another thing.
You seemed...
I was very happy with how that turned out.
Yeah, you seemed positive about it.
I was... it was fantastic. It's everything you want it to be.
Now, what made this stand out for you?
The new thing we're on, the therapy that we're doing and all that.
Oh,
good
are
stuff.
You doing some therapy?
Yeah, we're doing all of that.
Like a couples therapy?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, you're in it.
Yeah.
You go to see a person.
Well, no, I didn't mean to talk about this. In fact, I said I didn't want to talk about this before we got on.
But you go see a person?
Yeah, we see a person.
In person or are you doing it on Zoom?
No, we go to see them.
Oh, you're in the office.
Mm-hmm.
And you and your wife go together.
Mm-hmm.
And you have an hour?
An hour.
How long you been doing this?
I think I would.
What, Jerry?
3-4 weeks.
Okay.
Yeah.
And how are you feeling about it?
I'm happy about it. I like talking.
You feel like it's been helpful and going well.
Right. It's nice to do what I'm doing now without it having being recorded and being confronted with it.
Right.
Right.
No, I feel good about it. I'm pro therapy.
I've always been pro. It's the one job I think I could have done well. Because I can listen to other people's problems all day.
Yeah, you could basically do it.
Yeah.
Like, you don't need a degree.
No.
You don't need, you know, you can basically just say you're a therapist.
Before the
therapy. I'm going to give it a shot, maybe.
You should. Before the real therapy, this was sort of it. This is sort of like a dump. Like, you just dump everything out on this.
Let's not refer to it that way.
Well, exactly. You know, it's a whole, like, mind thing. I mean, you get to use improv and all your, you know, that was my therapy. But it's an aggressive type of therapy because you have to, you know, you have to be on your P's and Q's a tad. But when you're in therapy talking about someone else to somebody else, you know what I mean? And then they relay it back. It's a triangle. It's very, very interesting. And it's nice to talk at, give a reason while the other person can't talk, which is something I can't get you to do. And what then, just be quiet so I can do this whole show myself. And then then the therapist does that and we just need a third person in front of us.
Yeah, well, we have it.
Oh,
thank you.
Yay.
Thank you for joining us.
I'm only kidding.
Thank you for helping.
I'm only kidding. But man, Joseph, we just said we didn't want to talk about that earlier, did we?
I did not know you guys were doing some couples therapy. Mm-hmm. I'm glad to learn that you are.
We had to go on through a rough patch.
Man,
yeah. And it was a lot of honesty. And one of the things you got to confront, you might, and you should, is why can't we build upon that and find a reason that we're not doing it as much as we should be doing? So it's, you know, do you need a therapist? No. But it's nice to have that sounding board.
It's always nice.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yeah. I recommend it for anyone who can make it happen.
This was the first segment on our feminism podcast.
That the new feminine Nightbird.
The Night Vagina.
Yeah. Wow. Okay. Wow. So this is exciting. I can hardly process this. I'm high as fuck.
Yeah.
I'm trying to figure out what this is all about. I'm just happy. I'm happy about it.
I appreciate that.
I'd love to know more. I would like to know. I would like an actual recording of each session.
Oh, I'll sneak it in. We'll play it on the podcast.
No, you're allowed to record your own session. I mean, goddamn it, yours.
I'm not going to do that.
And then we'll play it on here and we'll, like, comment on it in real time.
We'll do one of these.
My God, that would be fucking fantastic.
If we get 10,000 likes, 10,000 likes and 500 real dollars,
dude,
we'll do that.
Okay. All right.
We're not going to do that.
No.
I'm not going to do that.
Wait, let's examine this.
That's a huge violation of trust.
Who's trust?
Of the bond that we have that we're trying to.
What bond?
What we're trying to build. If I were to actually.
That would build our bond so much.
I'm not talking about me and you, man. I'm talking me and my wife.
Let's focus on what's important here, brother. I mean, goddamn, we're doing a show.
Yeah. I think the therapy session would probably be better if you were to reenact it rather.
All right. How about this?
Record it.
How about this? Oh, God. This is Jerry. You know how once in a while you have like a mind-blowing good idea?
Yeah.
Like, I've just had this. Like, right now.
We can't say the first one because then we will copyright it.
I'm about to blow your fucking mind. This is the best idea I've ever had.
Feminism podcast. In my life. The music store.
No. When you guys go to therapy, mm-hmm. when you do your couples therapy.
Right.
This is the best.
I don't like it.
Jerry.
I already don't like it.
Okay.
If there's a part you should edit out of any of these things, it'd probably be this, the minute of us waiting. And I am so fucking high that it doesn't even matter, man. Let's just hear this.
Okay.
I'm up with the button.
No. Don't ever do that.
Listen. I didn't know that existed.
Listen. Okay.
Okay.
God.
Okay.
When you guys go to therapy.
Better be worth it, man.
I'm going to come too.
Okay. I want to introduce.
What do you think about
I want to introduce another perspective. And there comes polyamory Joseph.
Hey, man. Wouldn't that be great? Because then I'd be there to like. You know, all for my insight.
For some reason you'd have headphones on.
Your insight.
You've been giving your insight and it's been rejected.
I think it'd be valuable.
What?
And
when has it been valuable?
And the therapist could be there to validate my insight to you and Deb.
Oh, so this would be, you want to be proven
right. I could be
right.
Like, blah, blah, blah. Yeah. Right, doc? And she'd be like, you know, he's right.
Okay,
you guys.
So you want a validation
Yes, that's what I want.
A medical professional.
Yes.
A doctor should look at you and say, hey, you got to figure it out, man.
That's right.
Is that what you wanted?
No, I mean, that's a bit of sort an exaggeration, but a level of that, yes.
Yeah. Okay, I'll introduce a third protein, man, and come with me. I'm bringing Joseph. You bring who you want. What? Like some sort of royal. All right.
Well, this is good, Jerry.
Yeah.
So I assume, you know.
I would bounce of you going and sitting. You were there doing it for a minute.
It was fun, right? That's a good idea. Tell me, that's a great idea.
Oh, no, that is a dastardly and awful idea.
No, come on.
Why would you be there?
I want to like make sure everything's all right.
Okay. Well, thank you. You know? I'll bring a written copy.
Why, let me ask you, Jerry, why exactly is it a man or a woman that you see?
I see a woman.
Why is it that that woman knows so much better than I do? Like, why?
She, well, okay.
Really?
The doctorate helps.
But does it?
Yeah.
Why?
Because they did that and you didn't. That's a simple and basic explanation as to why I'm going to take her opinion.
So are you, to talk to her, are you inherently, you're a man with not even a high school diploma.
I have a GED. I think we're both in the same canoe with that one.
Well, it's not. I have a college degree, a legitimate college degree.
In what?
Listen, Jerry, can we stay on topic?
Okay. Yeah. So but I'm trying to make a point.
I'm not.
To the person who went to Cambridge.
No, you're misunderstanding where I'm going with this.
Okay.
You're being defensive and you shouldn't be.
I'm not being defensive.
Because I'm on Team Jerry.
I understand you are.
I'm saying that you don't even have a high school diploma.
Mm-hmm.
Does that mean to you, and I'm going to assume the answer is no, but does it mean to you that you're like worse off and less knowledgeable than every single person who does have a high school diploma?
You talk to that person.
No. And, I'm talking to you.
What, do I think I'm lesser than?
Yeah, are you dumber? Are you less knowledgeable than every single person who does have a diploma?
I mean, who knows? It's subjective. It's depends on the fact. I know that
the truth is, of course you're not.
Yeah.
That's ridiculous.
Oh, yeah.
You're probably smarter than half the motherfuckers that have their stupid diploma.
I don't know about that, but like,
well, you probably are.
Yeah, well, we try.
You're a bright man.
I appreciate that.
You have creative inclinations. You've had a level of variety and experience in your life through living around the globe and you know, you've had a rich life, you know, relative to so many others.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, you're relatively articulate. You're inaccurate, but you are articulate.
Yeah, I can say it nicely.
But I
appreciate
me?
These words. You know? I'm picking up what you're putting down. There is a lot of, like, what I think is common sense. And I think we all go through it where we think there's a level of common sense in somebody.
Sure.
And you're shocked that it's not there. Like, and it's not you being right or wrong. But it's just simple, easy living. You know, like, you shouldn't be doing that. You shouldn't be saying that. You know what I mean? Or you should be doing that. You should be doing that. It's interesting. But I understand. And now that you put it in that perspective, yeah. I mean, but this person comes from a clinical perspective, which almost makes me more, it's not totally clinical. There's a lot of emotion in psychology.
Yeah.
But it's more, I don't know. It feels like it can be said to this thing.
Sure.
You know, and not to belittle that person, but that she's a vessel to something greater.
Yeah.
And that's her function.
Well, Jerry, let's wrap this up by saying I am glad that this seems to be working out for you in these early stages, and that I hope that it does lead to more satisfying and spontaneous sexual interactions in your home.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Wow. This is a super positive. And I do appreciate I don't know what to say.
Yeah, I mean, I feel.
That was really nice.
That's how I feel.
The Nightbird, it's just so fucking crazy.
See, you know, I want to take one moment, guys. I want to thank our Lord Jesus H. Christ for his invention of marijuana.
Thank you.
Cannabis. Lord, thank you. Thank you for cannabis. Amen.
Amen. And there we go. 20 minutes.
How beautiful is it?
20 minutes of this.
What?
It's twice as 20 minutes.
Okay, fine.
No,
guys.
I'm good with that, but I love
it. I'm going to get on.
It'd be great we're going to have a 1994 playlist, and it was just a real, like, it was just us, like, just jerking off all over each other. Like, you're a good guy, too, man. And your head of hair is just impeccable every fucking time. I love your family. I love the dogs.
I mean, you're short as fuck. and your pants are way too big.
There we go. All right.
But I love you.
Thank you. I love you too. Got to man up and call you a pile of shit now.
Jerry?
God. I'm only kidding. Let's go.
We've got quite a bit of listener feedback we're going to listen to.
We're still doing this. Yeah, we'll get there.
I'm going to read them. I should say the website. Guys, if you like what you're hearing,
yeah, go to that.
Go to thegrungepodcast.com and you'll find links to all of our social media platforms with which you should join and interact with us.
Help our algorithm.
We have nude pics of Jerry, and there's a lot of that going on.
I forgot about that thing.
Yeah.
And I didn't forget about
Hang on now, Jerry.
2 days ago, and I'm like, I don't want that fucking thing.
You'll also find a link to our generous and vibrant Patreon channel. If you join on there with us, you will get double the episodes.
Double. Even triple sometimes.
That's true. We do a ridiculous amount of bonus episodes because we're insane.
Right. And on his free time, Joseph's free time, he does the monthly mushroom and Stony Baloney. And even on my free time, I play video games badly.
Right.
For the Grunge Podcast games at the Grunge Podcast Games.
So if you go there, guys, you can do a bunch of stuff. Oh, and you can also request what album you want us to do an episode on. And we will do it.
Very soon.
All right. It has begun. The requests have officially started rolling in. And soon enough, we will do it. Okay. On with the show. Should I get to some listener feedback?
We should probably see.
Save what, Jerry?
Which one? What are we talking about? Nice. What do you just read? Whatever you're going to read. Sorry.
All right.
I interrupted there.
Okay, Jerry.
Talking about.
We got a message from William. William says, just caught up to your Nirvana Unplugged episode. I know Joseph is very indifferent towards Nirvana, and while I am a fan of them myself, I would say Joseph's dislike toward them and Kurt specifically is understandable. With that being said, Nirvana's Unplugged session is one of the best shows I've heard that has some bittersweet feelings to it. Each band member brings their A game, in my opinion, and some of the cover songs, mainly Oh Me and Where Did You Sleep Last Night, is one of those songs I always come back to. High, and this had a weird space here. It sucks that this is the end of Nirvana, as Joseph's pain adds an element of humor to the podcast.
Oh, wow.
Keep up the good work. You guys rock.
I felt the same way, though. Like, as much as the ride we went on, like, it was I even said it on the podcast. Like, that's the first one we're done.
I've got a little bit of the cannabis-induced dry mouth.
Yeah, that's why I asked for water. Water. But, I felt a little, I don't want to do that, but I felt a little, I was sort of melancholy about the whole thing. Like, oh, what? It was sort of sad that they're not going to be there anymore.
Well, cry me a river, guys. All right?
You know, hey.
We've got a special message coming up here. Holy shit, Jerry. This is a message for you, my brother.
Okay.
Hang on. Our pal Mara, our lovely patron Mara.
Yes, winner of the Sexual Potential shirt.
Thanks for the definitely more than slightly used Sexual Potential t-shirt.
I didn't promise fucking.
I, of course, reworked it a lot. And since Jerry mentions 90s hip-hop often enough on the show, I hope he gets the reference. Great shows and happy belated birthday to Jerry.
Thank you, Mara.
We've got photos here, Jerry,
oh,
of Mara's reworking of the shirt. I will present them to Jerry right now. There are two photos right there. Take a good look, Jer.
Yo, sexual right. potential. It's the OMTV Raps insignia.
What do you think of that?
Oh, that's wonderful. Yeah, I hope. Did she put pockets in it?
I don't know. Did she? She may have.
She put pockets in it. Oh, that's so creative. Good for her. Mara, thank you. You made something. It was more than used. Well, there's some stuff. Yeah, but like she made it beautiful. Wonderful, Mara. Yeah, thank you so much.
She's creative. You
know what? That is staggering that somebody would do something that I made. And it took me hours.
Did it, Jerry?
Sure.
Did it.
Nice. It glows in the dark, though. She should know. I hope she knows that.
Yeah. Yeah. So, Mara, that was pretty fucking awesome.
It's really fucking cool. You put pockets in it. Yo, MTV Raps. I love it. Yo, Sexual Potential.
All right. We've got one more. We've got quite a message here from another one of our loyal, lovely patrons, the fantastic Crystal Boudreaux.
Hit, yes. Hit a sound that we
oh,
like.
My bad, my bad. Yeah. Crystal. Crystal says, I wish there was a more eloquent way to start this message, but I'm simply overwhelmed by the amount of joy the Versus episode brought me. Mm. I loved the other Pearl Jam episodes so much, and I will admit my expectations were particularly high for Versus. It really is the gift that keeps on giving. The energy going into this one was contagious and electric, a welcome change of pace after the In Utero episode for sure, which I still really enjoyed, by the way.
Hmm.
The episode really showcased what I love about the grunge. The facts were plentiful but not overbearing, and the commentary paired with one-sided enthusiasm could not be more entertaining for me as a fellow Pearl Jam fan. How could anyone not freak out about the end of Rearview Mirror? Thanks for another fantastic episode and for consistently being the number one music and information podcast. P.S. Jerry, thank you for being relatively well-behaved this time. I won't fault you for hating on Blood, but I will need to mentally prepare for your inevitable negativity regarding Vitology.
I actually like Vitology.
Well, I should hope so because it's better than 99.999% of the albums ever created in the entire universe.
That's not true.
It's true.
It's not accurate.
Jerry, I've got a college degree.
I'm sorry.
If I say it, it's right.
Right.
Don't get me upset.
Okay.
That's all right.
It's not harsh.
I am high. I'm in a vibe. We have candles, guys. We have actual fires burning inches away from us. Mm-hmm. In addition to some modern day fucking electronic
birthday gifts.
Candles happening here.
I got birth. Oh, I have.
All right.
We had Nightbird. I forgot about the wing.
Oh, put your fucking mask on, bro.
Nah, it hurts my eyes, man.
But Jerry, you gotta wear the
mask. We can't waste any time here.
Well, we're gonna be wasting time. We're waiting for you to put on your goddamn Nightbird costume.
Is this what that is?
Yeah. Oh.
Okay, go ahead. You can hold on a second.
All right. Well, we're gonna have our playlist. Our playlist tonight is right about an hour long, 59 minutes, I think. And I should let everybody know, like I always do, trigger warning, guys, trigger warning. There's going to be a variety of musical styles on this. I tried to sequence it in a way that was pleasing and made sense, although there are some, you know, left turns, okay? Should we get into it, Jerry? Do you have anything you want to input here while you don your Nightbird costume?
Man.
Guys, he's got the mask on.
Man, let's get the show on the fucking road.
Are you ready?
I'm ready.
All right, let's do it.
All guys. Right.
Track number one.
This okay. was key.
All right.
Yes.
Regulators.
This is my first ever. This is my first ever exposure to Nate Dogg.
Right. Guys, this is, of course, Warren G featuring Nate Dogg.
Right. I mean,
regulate.
God, this hurts my eyes. I don't know that. But
it was a clear black night,
yeah.
A clear white moon.
God damn, son.
On the streets trying to consume some
skirts for the. Did they use this? Michael McDonald they used, or what was the beat? Is that Steely Dan? I don't know who. I think it's Michael McDonald actually.
Missing trying to find Mr. Warren G. Seen a car full of girls, ain't no need to
trip.
No
tweet.
Come on, sir.
But I think if you think about a hip hop, and if you put Nate Dogg on a song, it was immediately a hit. And this was the beginning of all that.
Time is it.
I like this song, but I need to know the time and weather.
I'm gonna eat my edibles, so I need to know what time it is.
And 68 degrees here in Philadelphia. There's a small accident on I-95. I would love to do that. I think that'd be the best job in the world, is to be a traffic guy.
What, Jerry?
I would love to be a traffic guy on TV.
All right.
Seems like such a great. You're just looking at.
What do you think of this jam?
Oh no, this was timeless.
I like it.
I love Orange.
Yeah.
He had such a smooth flow.
I love this shit.
And then with coupled with Nate Dogg,
dude.
But I think you can. Nate Dogg's been on at least 15 gold albums. I swear to God.
Yeah, he got around.
His singles
If he's on them, he doesn't get enough credit, Nate Dogg. Like, he should be in a Hall of Fame of sorts. Fantastic voice.
I could listen to a beat like this.
Oh, my God, yeah.
That early 90s West Coast vibe. God damn, that is, to me, that's my hip-hop.
That's, yeah, I was more into the jazzy sound of the East Coast, like the more frantic.
Yeah, this was my shit here.
I remember this is one of the songs that turned me on, because Ice Cube wasn't making music like this.
Yeah.
And his shit was always like, bah! Yeah, you know, I'm wrong, you know, and all that other stuff.
Yeah, this the G-Funk shit, that is my shit.
Who did the beat?
What?
That was back before we knew who the producers were. Like, before producers started singing in the videos, dancing in the videos.
The zany producer.
Yeah, the zany producer, like DJ Clue. DJ Clue, 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 fire!
Yeah, there's some pretty fucking killer DJ Clue jams.
Well, DJ Clue goes. You know he's there.
Yeah.
Because he says his name. God damn.
I do love those beats.
Jesus. This is Michael McDonald's. That's what you know. But it's a...
don't fucking know, Jerry.
I shut my phone off. I can't look
good
at it.
Turn that shit off.
I just want to know who was the producer.
Fuck that.
Into a whole new era. Hear that? There's almost old school, like 80s flow, you know?
The rhythm is the bass and the bass is the treble. Chords,
strings, we brings. Man, like, God damn it, this bird.
Cherry, you're hurting the bird.
And life is rhythm. You know what I know.
Wow.
Step to this, yeah. It's the G-Funk era, bumped out with a gangster twist. If you smoke like I smoke, then you're high like every day. And if your ass is a buster, 213 will regulate. 213 was the band with I think it was Snoop Dogg, Nate Dogg, and Warren G in it. That was the beginning.
Oh, Jerry. Oh, fucking Jer.
Yeah.
Fucking Jerry having sex.
Petting the bird.
You guys gonna get crazy? You gonna get it? You're gonna get a little paddle?
Nope.
You gonna get some handcuffs?
Hey, let's baby steps, baby.
You gonna get in some of that electric stuff where you electrocute each other a little bit?
I don't want to talk about something gross, but I saw something gross.
Well, then don't.
All right.
Because I don't like gross shit.
You don't want to talk about insertion?
No.
All right. Because I'm ready to talk about insertion.
Here's a jam, Jerry.
I remember this. Me and my sister, we used to travel a lot, so we'd have hotel pools and stuff like that.
This is Sabotage.
This is Sabotage
from Beastie Boys.
So me, if we were ever in a hotel and there was a pool, I would be Sir Stuart Wallace and look out the door, and I would run, and my sister would chase me as one of the cops. And when I and there was a stunt here where they tackled each other in the pool. So I would run, turn around like the Beastie Boys video, and then she would tackle me as hard as she could into the pool.
That's nice.
It was just like the video. This video was fantastic. God, the Beastie Boys.
Yeah.
Have you heard any of their jazz music? Any of the stuff they did?
Yeah, I mean, back then, you know. I never got too deep into the Beastie Boys, really.
I was a fan of Paul's Boutique. I mean, what?
Man, I want to eat some snacks.
Yeah, you have too many. 1988, 1987, when did Fight for Your Right come out?
I don't fucking know.
Well, it was early. So I didn't like them then.
I mean, I did like them then.
I didn't. It wasn't until Paul's Boutique that I really got into them. And then their
I got some Almond Joy.
I like whatchamacallit.
Meeting it.
I was at Innerborough's junior prom, and they turned this song on.
That's a gnarly bass sound.
It is.
Sound right there. Little bass line.
And they turned this song on, and then people started like moshing. And then they shut the song off midway. The song was great. They had this. Oh, no, Check Your Head was good, too. So I can't say Paul's Boutique. I like because I have What You Want on it. That was good. Love that tune.
Sabotage.
Two hip-hop songs, sort of, in a row. Not normal for us. I can't wait for the inevitable Dio song.
I'll do this for you, Jerry.
Thank you. Will there be a Dio song?
Let's fucking hope.
I mean,
94. We're doing 14 albums.
That's right.
Wow.
We got 14 episodes, including this one.
That is something.
Yeah. That's 7 episodes of the main podcast and 7 bonus episodes.
It's going to take a month and a half to get through.
Quite a while.
Wonderful. It's good to know.
This is a great jam, guys. I'm sure you know it, or you should. Plowed.
Yeah.
From Sponge.
Yeah. I forgot about this song.
Yeah. Take it for granted, man. This is a jam you take for granted.
You
heard it a million times. You didn't ask for it any of those times.
You're right.
Really give it a listen. Mm-hmm. Really, it's a strong fucking jam.
Somebody talked about us doing this album.
Yeah.
And I think...
we're not going to.
Okay.
But we're going to listen to this song.
That's not on the schedule, I take it.
No.
Yeah, man. I mean, how many times has this song
been... that just...
yeah, so good. How many times
it's
have you been in the car and it was just on the radio?
That's a great song.
You don't think anything of it. It was perfect the way you said it. Like, you didn't ask for it. It happened.
And we're lucky. We're lucky to have it.
It's a rolling jam.
I love that part.
It doesn't stop either.
Yeah. And that dude, Vinny, I think his name is, he just nailed this song. He really nailed it. There's almost a weird, almost somber tone to the song for me. Like, there's almost a somber tone to this song. I don't know.
It sounds like there's a yearning, or something. He's saying something in earnest.
Yeah.
Not yearning, but in earnest. He's saying it, and he's saying it powerfully. Because he doesn't, like, it just keeps going this way, and the music gets faster. And it ramps up perfectly. Look at me, I'm bouncing.
Really a great vocal sound on this song, too. The mix is great. It's a great song.
Yeah, it also helps that I like it now, even, like, just, and there's so many things rushing back to me from this time period. This would be one of the quintessential songs of the 90s, then.
For sure.
It's almost, it harkens. It'd be nice if this was being played nowadays.
Man, that's great. It's fucking great.
Yeah. Solid song. I wish I've never heard the whole album, though. I'm going to be honest. I wish I did.
Yeah, I did own it, but I can't say it was super memorable. You know, it didn't stick with me.
It blended in with everything else, unfortunately.
Yeah.
I think when these get 94, 93, these guys were in the middle of that. Like this vortex, you know?
They had another jam that I really loved, that Wax Ecstatic song from their second album. I love that song, but this one.
I love that. It only slowed down till the end. And that's fantastic.
A little change of pace here, sort of. All right, little conspiracy.
I'm unfamiliar.
From the Black Crowes.
Well, if we can play the Black Crowes, we should always play the Black Crowes.
Hell yeah.
Still, I still say catch a licking.
Catch a licking.
Catch a licking. And people at work, I said to people at work, what the? Jesus, I haven't heard that. Fucking 80s.
They were so good, man. Those early Black Crowes albums, the first 3-4 albums are so good.
They felt, I didn't give them a fair shot because they looked too country to me back then. And then with Remedy, it was a very southern sound, you know? So I didn't give them a lot of a chance, you know?
Yeah.
I lumped them in with Skinner, and I should
have. Oh, no.
That was foolish.
Yeah, they're just so good. Was it this? I can't remember what song it was. It could have. Was it this? I don't know. I'm too stoned to remember, but they did a video for a song from one of these earlier records. And Chris Robinson looked like Marilyn Manson in the video. Like, he looked crazy. He was, like, painted.
Yeah.
Like, it was wild looking.
He's an artist. He was always going. Like, he looked sick all the time to me. He looked tired.
Back then, yeah, he was just skinny and
skinny, weird-looking, getting with Kate Hudson type motherfucker, you know? I mean,
he looks really kind of good nowadays. Him and his brother have gotten back together. Mm-hmm. And they're out there, you know, those two are notoriously feuding, yeah, like fist fights. You know, they were worse than fucking Oasis.
The kinks were bad too for that.
Yeah. And they're back together now, and they're out there. Well, before COVID, they were out there touring around as the Black Crowes. And it's just those two with, you know, new guys in the band. But who gives a fuck? It's Rich and Chris Robinson. That's the Black Crowes we care about. And they're out there just faithfully recreating those early songs, playing them like the way we want them to fucking play them.
You get what you pay for when you go to see the band, you know?
Yeah, and I'm so glad that they have worked that out.
Awesome.
And are, you know, allowing people to hear those songs played by those guys.
I forget their existence. I do remember the album cover to one of their band, one of theirs, the pubic hair one.
Amorica.
That was the one I remember. We had to put a sticker over it and shit like that every time it came in. I think they later put another version of it out to sell it at Walmart.
Yeah. Yeah, that's right.
I used to get it confused with Weezer's. Weezer had a similar cover, but they had a big Weezer
belt. Has the music been really loud? Relative to our voices.
I think people have been clamoring for us to turn the music up.
Yeah, really? Oh, yeah.
Plus, we like these songs.
Oh, God, we got to address this. We got to review.
I
don't even want to talk about it
right
now.
We'll talk about it.
This song.
Yeah, it's so different.
Some fucking nerd out there.
Ask some guy.
What's his name?
I don't know.
I'm going to shout his name out next time.
No, it's not. It's
Thomas something.
It's one negative review.
This fucking nerd.
Guy like me.
He left an iTunes review, a negative review.
Oh, yeah, it was murder.
That was about 17 pages long. Like, really. Like, it was weird.
And we talked about it.
But wait. Yeah. That's like, and also, I'm not even trying to be funny. Like, all right, that's shitty. Okay, he left a bad review. Okay, whatever. But that's like disturbing behavior.
Well,
like, people that love the show, they write like a little short paragraph, maybe.
Right.
Like, I really love the show. These guys are cool, blah, blah, whatever. This guy, like, if you look at it, guys, it is like a fucking research paper just shitting on the show. Primarily me. Which I don't care. I love negative reviews. You know, I think they're hilarious.
And this was funny.
I love negative reviews. I love when people are upset by the show.
Oh, yeah. I can't think.
But in all seriousness,
it's a podcast.
I think that guy is disturbed.
I think.
Like, what kind of life must you have to take the time out to write that down?
The writing's one thing. That's a little weird. I can't think of a more user-friendly version of saying, fuck that, I don't want to listen to it. Like, midway through, you should turn it off.
Yeah, dude, by all means, stop listening.
I mean, because
you can tell he's listened to it a lot.
You can't. It's not like change of channel.
He knows a bunch of stuff about the show.
We're not like TV, where, like, it's always on that channel.
Right.
You can't get away from it. You can avoid us.
You have to try to listen to us.
Yeah, dude, we ain't.
You had to tell an application to download this for you.
Yeah, dude, we ain't paying.
Okay?
Yeah, like, seriously, and you did it, and then
this is fucking Blues Traveler playing Runaround.
Yeah,
I never gave a fuck about this song.
Yeah, me neither.
Now I can look back on it humorously and think, okay, that's a fun little song.
It reminds
song.
Me of NBC sitcoms.
it's a good song.
It's there. I always marveled at his Chewbacca belt that he would have.
Yes.
Or the bandolier of harmonicas that he would wear. I'm like, is there that many?
Yeah.
You know? How many different versions of this shit is there? But you know what?
But yeah, anyway, this nerd, he's real fucked up.
Did you ever pick up a harmonica? Can you play a harmonica?
Not really. No, I don't even think I ever had like a real harmonica.
I want to be Bruce Willis good at the harmonica.
No, very few of us can ever reach that level.
Turn to Bruno.
It's a good song. I mean,
they were talented artists.
Like, I never want to listen to their album, but like, this is a good song.
It's like Dave Matthews to me. You know, like, I respect the musicianship that goes into it.
Right.
And some of those songs, like Crash, I love, you know?
Dave Matthews Band, you know, they certainly have some good songs.
Yeah,
I'm not going to sit there and listen to a Dave Matthews Band album.
And it's just like
I'm
Blues
sure
Traveler.
As fuck never going to go to one of their concerts with those people. But,
it's like, it's a jam band crowd.
Yeah. Not even those people, but I'm sure those people are fine. I just can't get into Dave Matthews Band.
Joseph, you know what you mean.
Well, you know, I think a lot of people, I don't even know if this is true, but in my mind, a lot of people that like Dave Matthews Band are probably into Pearl Jam.
Yeah.
Why would Right? Is that a thing?
Yeah.
I don't know. I mean, I just don't have any interest. I don't think, like, that show would annoy the fuck out of me.
Well, it would because it was played. I mean, at every carnival, you heard of Dave Matthews. What would you say? You know, and I remember hearing it. See, it was a new sound.
But I would imagine, and again, I have the most rudimentary knowledge of Dave Matthews Band. I don't know shit. I've never seen them. I don't know anything. But I bet you, I could see Dave Matthews Band being the type of thing where you go see them and you don't even hear that. They don't even play that
I think they play
just 42-minute long jam versions of the songs.
Well, they're not Fish.
I think
Fish,
they might be.
I think they might be that kind of deal.
I don't know. I'm not sure.
I had a friend who just used to go around Fish selling nitrous. And that, would be his thing, you know, and that was...
Nitrous.
Yeah, nitrous. I can't think of a more damaging drug that lasts for a little bit of time. It kills
perhaps
every
heroin.
Time you do nitro. At least there's something. With nitrous, you only get like high for like 30... Like, seconds, I think.
I am so curious about heroin.
But no, I'm not. No movie has ever made that look good.
Well, the reality of heroin is not good. I mean, we know this.
Yeah,
and when you see movies,
like,
they want to portray that. They're like, this is a gross, like, devastating, whatever type of space you can get in.
Body.
But what I think about is, what kind of drug would it take to make people do that to themselves?
Meth.
No. I mean, what kind of drug would it take to make people do that? It must be amazing.
It must be amazing. Apparently, the first hit. I mean, this is from talking to other people, too. The first hit is the best hit ever.
Yeah, euphoria. True euphoria.
Yeah, you tapped into everything.
And who doesn't want true euphoria? I want to experience that.
Well, I don't want heroin.
Well, no. I'm saying we don't do it because we're scared of being on heroin. You know what I mean?
That's a thing.
We're scared of all the downsides. I'm just saying that the upside must be so good. That's what makes people so fucking addicted.
It's only the effect. Yeah. I mean, as any drug, it's only the effect.
Well, yeah, that's why they do it. They don't want to be fucked up and addicted to heroin.
No.
They want that euphoria. And it's so good, you can hardly fucking fight yourself away from it.
A lot of the people we're covering were on that. Not John Popper, by a long shot.
John Popper.
John Popper was on heroin.
I don't know what he was on.
Number one.
John Popper died from heroin.
He should have gone on Grunge.
Is he still alive?
You know, if we just said, like, if we could go back and put
Is he alive or did he die?
He's still alive.
He
lost a lot
of weight.
What's
up, John Popper?
Yeah. If we replace Kurt Cobain with John Popper, you think people would be upset?
Yeah, of course. We should do it right now.
Eddie Vedder, Chris Cornell, Lane Staley,
John Popper.
The Godfathers
We're
of Grunge.
Exploring the catalog of John Popper.
Just John Popper, not Blues Traveler.
Well, no, I like his solo work better.
Yeah, he did this.
Did he ever make a solo album?
He did this on the City of Angels soundtrack.
Oh, here you go, Jerry.
Oh, there we go.
Okay.
What the fuck? We just blew our
1994.
Blew our Dave Matthews load right there. Now what am I going to talk about?
John Popper.
Hootie's next. I bet you there's a Hootie and a Blowfish song on this. Because there has to be.
Oh, Jerry.
Because that's there.
Well, if there isn't a Hootie and the Blowfish song on this list, what does that mean?
It wouldn't be complete.
Well, what would that mean?
Look, there was no fucking answer. Huh?
What would it mean to you if there was no Hootie and the Blowfish song on this playlist?
It wouldn't mean anything to me.
It would mean something.
I just know it's there.
Well, what are the rules about these playlists? Do you remember?
I don't know. Your thing.
No. We have two rules for the Nightbird playlist.
Okay.
You don't remember them?
I just thought.
I guess there's technically three rules. One rule is I have to like it.
Yeah, that's the one.
Okay.
But
there's two real rules.
Cascades.
Well, no. The one rule is it has to have come out in this year.
Yeah, and you have to like it.
And it has to not be on an album that we're going to do an episode on.
Oh, so Sponge. Oh, yeah.
So if we don't have a Hootie song on this playlist...
We're going to have a Hootie album. Let's not say that publicly.
Well...
Let's edit that part out.
Guess we just did.
I wish we could censor it with... What about Blowfish?
Hey, guys. By the way, this is Satellite... From Dave Matthews Band.
It must be great live.
I'd like to see Dave Matthews Band live for 30 minutes.
I just want to see what it looks like.
Yeah, I want to just see a 30-minute set of, like, their good songs. Like, you know, they are very strong musicians. Their drummer is a fucking monster drummer. Monster drummer. Carter Beauford or something. He's a tremendous drummer. And Dave Matthews is a legit guitar player for sure. If you like his style, then great. It's not for everybody.
I think it spawned a lot of our Jack Johnsons and the guy who fucks celebrities. What's his name?
John Mayer.
John Mayer.
It's funny that I know who you mean by saying that, but John Mayer.
That's awesome.
John Mayer does a great cover. I have a recording of him doing Free Fallin' from Tom Petty, and I enjoy it. I like the way the little fuck does it.
He's okay. He's not little either. He's tall as hell.
I'll kick his fucking ass.
Okay. Andre 3000 and John Mayer.
I'll kick the shit out of both of them in the same afternoon. I don't give a fuck.
Bring a lunch, motherfucker. Joseph's kicking the shit out of him.
All right, it's 9:15 p.m., Jerry. Should I consume a gummy on top of this tremendous amount of weed that I did?
I don't think so.
That could put me near death.
Yeah. Reefer madness. But
let's do it. I want to one day find out
he makes his own.
Just how high a human man can get.
You won't. You'll stop being high. I promise you, I've done it. You just hit it. You hit a brick wall. And
you stop being high.
You stop being high altogether, and nothing saves it. Promise you.
I'm going to try.
Yeah, try. You're just wasting money. Because I know the end.
Jerry, we know that generally, the truth is the opposite of whatever you say.
Okay. You're either going to fall asleep or sober up. These are the truths. You're going to eat yourself into a coma.
This song's nice, right?
I love it. No, I don't. I said that out loud. Yeah, it just has a sing-songy vibe, man.
You're that guy.
Yeah, I'm going to be that guy. You want to sing it. You know? Interesting voice.
Oh, man, we got a legit song coming up next. I just got a glimpse at the playlist.
No, don't look at that.
I know. I try not to look ahead. But I just got a glimpse, and I know what's coming up.
I hope it's another Snake Siskin song.
That is not the name, Jerry. Okay?
I'm gonna keep
Why don't you fuck off with
snake,
that?
Snake Bliskin.
Dude.
Escape from New York.
We're going to listen to that song every episode until you fucking get it. Until you rise to the level that it's on and understand how badass it is.
The people in Waco played Snake Bliskin. Until they gave up.
Six Blixen.
Psyops with Snake Bliskin. Kurt Russell. Fuck your president. I mean, that's what he said. Fuck your president.
Wow.
Coming in on a glider. Trying to escape Philadelphia. Oh, did you? I won't bring it up.
What?
Dude, I watched these debates, and he's like, bad things right, happen in Philadophia.
Oh, yeah. Oh. Legit song. Hitchbot. This next song is called Hard Luck Champion. It's from a fantastic band called Dangerous Toys.
Mm.
All right? This is from their, let me think about this, third album. I believe it's called Pissed. Little known. It is obscure. I must say it's a little on the obscure side.
Mm-hmm. No cool kids listen to this.
They had a minor hit with their first album, and after that, it was kind of downhill.
And this commercially. Is part of the downhill. Okay. I love that voice. I love that. Come on.
Love this dude.
This guy.
Jason McMaster. He's a bad motherfucker.
I knew Charlie McMaster. They're good, but is McMaster Scottish?
I don't know. He's got kind of red hair.
Oh, yeah. He's Irish, reddish. Now, tell me. How is this different than anything else? It sounds like
awesome.
Rocket Queen.
Rocket Queen is one of the best songs in the world.
It is a nicer because anything.
Dude, Rocket Queen?
Wait, not Rocket Queen.
Are you kidding me?
I'm talking about the. Not Rocket. Rocket Ride.
Oh, get out of here, Jerry.
It's the Rocket Ride.
Never confuse those two, by the way.
This just seems very paint by numbers to me.
Okay, Jerry.
I like it, sort
it's
of.
Just
I
mean, it's just a fucking rock song.
Well, our job is to talk over it, so I'm trying to help here.
But you find something better to say.
Okay. All right, let me search my memory banks.
Yeah, you think of something better.
They really put a lot of effort into this.
What kind of sex did you guys get up to, by the way?
You're going to change the subject?
I'm just saying.
We have to get through Dangerous Toys.
Yeah, we're getting through it.
I'm not going to talk about that. We're done.
No, but I mean...
I just covered that shit.
No, but what was... It was like...
Hey, homie. Oi.
You found it to be more spontaneous? Was that an element?
Which one's your mic?
Hold on.
How about I shut that down?
You found it to be more spontaneous?
It was very, very... Whatever, man. I'm not going to get into this right now. I'm trying to fucking do this podcast.
So it wasn't spontaneous.
It was.
Did she give you more of a schedule?
No, I didn't get a schedule. Joseph.
No, well, I have a friend.
I'm going to start fucking hitting buttons.
Let me tell you something. I have a friend who also entered into couples therapy with their partner. They are a married couple with children. And part of the, I don't know, prescribed whatever that they were supposed to do, their homework, was sort of to like have planned sex. Like the woman told them, like, okay, you guys need to have sex. Like, you have to make a time for it. You basically have to create a schedule for it so that it's a thing that will happen.
We're trying to distance ourselves from that.
From a schedule.
There wasn't really a schedule. There was opportunity, and we knew when there was opportunity, and we would bargain on that. But that takes a lot of... Anytime you're in a long-term relationship like that, you know, you get in where you fit, especially when you have a child. So you have to schedule things. Well, we're trying to do less of that.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Yeah, you want it to just be a spontaneous thing.
Your friend was more, you know, we have to do this.
Yeah, well, they were going from no sex.
Yeah, well, we're not doing that. But so we're trying to spice things up a tad. So it's
that's good.
I really fucking don't feel
adding a touch of spontaneity.
I think that's the last I'm going to talk about.
All right, Jerry. Until next time.
Yeah.
This is Burn from Nine Inch Nails. This is on the soundtrack.
This is on the Natural Born Killer soundtrack.
There you go. Let's say it was that one.
It wasn't Seven. Seven was Animal.
No. It was Natural Born Killers. Yeah.
I got taken to that movie at a very young age. I should not be watching Natural Born Killers. Like, I was always only like 15, you know?
Okay.
You had to be like 18 to get in there, you know, 18, 15, 16. And we had to lie to our...
Did I say what this is?
This is Burn by Nine Inch Nails. You said it.
Did I say that?
You did say it.
This is Nine Inch Nails,
No,
guys.
Here comes the gummy. So we had to tell him, no, we saw Milk Money, where a guy took in a prostitute and had her raise his kids.
Yes.
So I questioned.
Who's in that? Melanie Griffith?
It was Melanie Griffith and Ed Harris.
God, why do I know that?
because you probably passed by the poster seeing Natural Born Killers like we said.
Yeah.
You know, if you watch that again.
What?
Not Natural as good Born as you Killers? Remember.
I mean, it's just a crazy Oliver Stone freak out.
It was a sign. It was part of it. Like, this had a 90s. All the jump cuts and weird fucking...
Oliver Stone in the 90s was a madman. He was making some wild movies.
Yeah, he did. JFK was the 90s. I love that movie.
It's a crazy movie.
Well, John Candy, huh?
Yeah.
John Candy fucking takes it to the next level.
Yeah, John Candy kills it in that movie. God damn, that's his best performance, I think.
I'm going to go with that.
That's weird.
He was impressive.
Yeah, dude. Yeah, he really was great.
He didn't show his weight. I love Uncle Buck. Don't catch me lying.
Sure.
Uncle Buck, you know, I love that movie. But like when he won it, but you forget how big he is until he was in that movie when he was like
sweating,
just sweating the whole fucking time.
He's a bad motherfucker.
But if he stood up and wanted to beat your ass, John Candy will fuck you up.
Yeah.
God, I'm glad we got. I want that. Clip.
Hey, Nine Inch Nails.
Yeah, brings out the beast in John Candy.
That's fucking wild.
I love that shit. This is shit I would say I liked. If I was trying to, like, come off hardcore. As far as, like, an industrial guy.
That's fucking cool.
Filter jacked this sound immediately.
Filter.
Oh, you don't like Filter?
Oh, fuck that dude.
All right. He was in Nine Inch Nails.
Yeah, he was in there and just, you know, hired to play an instrument for a little while.
He looked the part.
Miss my dog died. Burn.
Hope my dog is okay in heaven. Should have put you on a leash, did not put you on the balcony.
Yeah.
You want to get on testosterone, Jerry?
What? No.
Like testosterone replacement therapy or
I've
something?
I've heard about that. And people who have done that type of thing, like athletes in college, in high school and college, what it does, it do, and it's not always the case, but they swear that it depletes your ability.
I mean, athletes in college shouldn't be on it.
Well, yeah, right. But you know.
Yeah.
You know. But it depletes your reserves, and it's harder for you to make. Now, I don't know if that's scientific. Again, don't...
No, that's true. Yeah, your body won't need to produce it.
And so it becomes harder to actually produce it.
No.
If you get off your cycle.
If you go off of it, your body will return to its normal level, not to the new level,
right.
You know. But the idea is to get on it to get back to a good level where you're at when you're like, you know, 22.
I don't like that shit. I would never do that.
No?
No.
I want to get on it.
Man, well, good for you, man. I'm not.
Everything I read about it and all the stuff, whenever people talk about it who are on it, it's super good. And it's all the things I want. It's just like, like it'll just improve your mood. You'll recover faster. You can just.
The benefits outweigh.
Get back.
It just doesn't. I don't know. I don't like taking that type of shit. I don't take. I try my hardest.
I mean, you know, I don't either.
Yeah,
you
know, I know.
But
we talk
in that
about
case,
prescription and all that stuff. I don't like prescription.
That's one that I always consider. I'm just like, God damn, I wish I could just try it. I don't know if it's like expensive.
I mean,
or
the results, if you put the effort in, are mind boggling.
Yeah, I want to. I got to do it. I should try it.
Thank you.
Hey, that was Nine Inch Nails.
Good job.
We're going on here to these Stone Temple Pilots.
Oh no, we're not going to cover this Crow soundtrack.
That soundtrack ain't that good.
I know. It's going to be a typo negative type thing. Like, fuck. Yeah. How much more of this is left?
But here's Stone Temple Pilots with Big Empty from the Crow soundtrack.
Big shout out to Doug Evasick. God, this was a good song, though.
Good jam.
I remember being okay with this being on the radio.
I like this little vibe they had here.
They were a capable band, Stone Temple Pilots. They could do a lot of things. Now, this was shortly after they were knocked on as about being like capitalizing on the Pearl Jam, Alice in Chains. They were being knocked around for being what were considered copycats.
Yeah.
And it's like this.
I don't remember the dates or whatever. This
is the year separated.
Well, yeah, but this came maybe between their first and second albums, or did it come out after the second album
know.
In the same year?
I think it was
either
on the
way.
Second album though. Was
is it? Is it on the second album?
I think it was.
Oh, it is.
I think. Don't know the.
Well, guys, listen, then maybe I fucked it up, but we are going to be covering Stone Temple Pilots.
Oh, yeah.
We're doing their second album.
That's why I said The Crow.
Yeah, if this song is on their album, then we're going to do it again, but
I wasn't thinking that. I don't know. Who knows?
I don't fucking know either. Listen, Jerry.
Man.
Sorry, guys. Write me a fucking iTunes review about it. Oh, also, guys, can you leave us a good iTunes review? If you're listening on iTunes, can you please... Or Apple Podcast review now. Can you just go on there and give us the 5-star review, please?
I hear that on every podcast I listen to. Please give us 5-star reviews. And
because every once in a while we're going to get a douche nozzle like this fucking guy who comes and gives us a low review because he's mad.
Even Conan O'Brien says give me a 5-star review. It's like, what's that? You know, I mean,
I don't know. It makes I think it's not.
I ask for it every day.
It's not that it matters, like, oh, we have a good review, but the reason it matters is because I think it affects, like, the algorithm of what podcasts get shown to people.
Oh.
And so if your podcast gets shitty reviews, maybe the Apple's algorithm is like, oh, well, it's shitty. Don't show it to people. So, you know, this fucking guy that was butthurt about Kurt Cobain with his ugly fucking baby and his fucking social media pictures, you know.
Hey, listen, you can leave. You're free to your own opinion.
It's just, his baby's ugly.
Yeah, okay. It's just, God damn. He took a gummy. He's the only man I know who smoked about an ounce of weed and got like super aggressive about some rando.
Hey guys, this is the Nightbird.
Yeah. Fuck that guy. Fuck his cat.
Well, if we were on mushrooms, I'll tell you what, I'd be in a lot better mood.
Okay. Great song. And couldn't be truer words spoken. Conversations do kill. Oh, it's not over yet. I never sounded more like a radio DJ. Great song. Hey now.
Oh my gosh. Wow. Jerry back on the weed right now. Just hitting that thing.
This is how I do it then. This is how I do it in the basement.
Yep. Jerry ended the song at the halfway mark.
That'd be my last day of fucking 102.9. All right. Midway through fucking... midway through Stairway to Heaven, just being like, all right.
I was just noticing... This is a little inside baseball here. Noticing, like, something happening on your mic channel, and I don't know why. Hold on one sec. Yeah, it was, like, blinking red. I don't know what could have possibly...
Can you hear me, though?
Yeah, but I don't know. This was, like... I swear I saw something red. I don't fucking know.
Tell me I was shut off this whole fucking show.
You've been off the whole show.
Oh, my God. Well, that's a waste of time.
Yeah, we're going to have to start over.
Oh.
Sorry, Jer. Or maybe people will think I'm crazy and I've just been here laughing and talking by myself the whole time.
This is gonna be a great story.
Maybe Jerry's just my imaginary friend. Are you not even fucking real?
That would be the reverse nightclub.
Man.
Fight club. Reverse nightclub.
We're like the opposite of a nightclub.
Have you ever seen...
Love this jam. Energy Sucker from Luscious Jackson. You don't know this, Jer?
No. I never got into them.
It's got a chill vibe.
Hey, dude, speaking of you having a...
Hold on now, Jerry.
We'll get to that.
My soul.
Speaking of just having an imaginary friend, somebody took a Garfield comic strip and cut Garfield's word balloons out.
Come on, Jerry.
And it's just John Arbuckle staring and yelling at this cat.
Come on, Jerry.
This is random.
You don't like this vibe? Seriously, close your eyes for a moment. Jerry, listen. No. Try me. Let me help you. Sit back. Close your eyes for a moment.
Okay. Close my eyes. What we got
feel
here?
Feel this. Yeah, Jerry, come on.
You got the pull of a riptide. Too tight, man. Soon you're gonna
see
me in. I better stay tough or you're gonna get me. Well, now I wish that you never even met me. You're the type.
This is a fucking shitty song, man.
Oh, come on, dude. What? Are you fucking kidding? No, you hate everything that you don't know already.
I don't know about that.
That's true.
I would give this all.
You've never heard a brand new song and liked it.
Luscious Jackson. No.
Every time we've ever played a song that you've heard for the first time, you didn't like it. 100%.
No, I'm gonna stay not liking this.
Yeah.
Hey, listen. I don't hate it. I like that little funky thing going on in the background.
Jerry hates
listen.
Everything he doesn't know.
Okay. Right. Yeah, right. I hate all...
You've never heard a song for the first time and been like, oh, man, that was actually really great.
That was great. Yeah, I've heard that before. I've done that before. What do you want me to say about this?
Never That's did it on this show.
I have.
No, you have not. What song?
Mother Love Bone. I didn't hear any of that shit. I never heard any of that.
On the show, you told me you had that album and you had listened to it before.
No, not that one.
They only have one, motherfucker.
I thought there was an EP.
Jerry lied. I'm going to cut this clip. I'm going to put it next to the clip of you saying you've heard them.
No, the EP. I'm not saying anything. There was
all the jams are on their one album.
Oh. I thought the first one we listened to was an EP I didn't know about. Is that the whole thing? Oh, yeah. Going for me. I can't think of a song that I like.
I know, because it hasn't happened.
No, but I can tell you I'm not going to like this.
Yeah,
it's okay. Listen, man, we can disagree.
All right, Jerry. Fucking negative motherfucker.
I'm not a negative motherfucker.
Negative motherfucker. I'm stone free.
I'm stone free. I gotta get out quick.
How dare you, Jerry? You start saying shit right now.
I'm not saying anything.
I said to start saying shit.
What are you talking about? What I'm trying to take this in. I'm trying to like the song, Joseph.
Well,
trying to give it a whirl.
You failed.
I did not like it.
Here comes a piece of shit song.
Okay.
Just put it on here for Jerry. Which I'll never do again.
Who will save your soul? People living their lives for you on TV. Jewel? Thank you, Joseph, for putting Jewel on. I've forever.
Yeah, I put this on for you.
You put on Who Will Save
Your Soul?
This
is the type of sissy ass shit you listen to.
Did I listen to Jewel?
You ain't listening to cool chicks, that's for sure.
Come on.
What
man.
Do you like better, this or Luscious Jackson?
I like this better.
Exactly. Because you've heard it before.
No, I didn't.
Not because it's great.
Come on, man. Listen, I'm allowed a different opinion here.
No, you're not.
I didn't like that song.
No, you're not.
That's foolish. Why am I fucking here if I agree with everything?
Because who am I going to talk to?
Yeah,
I don't even know if you're here. Fake ass motherfucker. Not even a real person.
Yeah, I've never been.
Fucking imaginary friend.
It would be so cool if, like, Jerry's drinking. I hate Jerry on alcohol, and I'm never there. Jerry's so, like, oh, Jerry, you're so wrong. Jerry is such a bigot, and there's no one there.
Dude, this would be so crazy. I would be so crazy if you weren't real.
If I wasn't real, I am real. Dude. I'm real right now. Don't try to do any stupid shit like pinch me or something.
Oh, yeah. If I cut you and you're not real, then it doesn't matter. I'm going to cut you.
And I'm going to fucking resist that.
Jerry, no resisting.
I'm gonna kill
no
you.
Resisting.
No.
I'll put you under citizen's arrest.
For attacking me with a knife?
It's your story against mine.
You're wearing a satanic shirt.
You're a fucking religious bigot, Jerry.
Oh, no.
Always with the religious persecution. Today's Blasphemy Day, by the way, everybody. International Blasphemy Day.
Somebody's stabbing somebody, and you're wearing a... You're not going to get the benefit of the doubt. I'm all blue. We're all blue.
Can I tell you? I rolled into the local Wawa early today with my big blasphemous inverted cross t-shirt that I'm wearing, everybody.
All right.
And boy, people did not enjoy it. Some of the shoppers...
You know where we're at.
At the Wawa.
You know where we live.
They were... Given the looks, they were upset by my shirt.
You confronted people with things.
And if I'm being really honest, I loved every second of it. I loved every second of it. Those motherfuckers.
Any Cradle of Filth shirt. Any of them. That's why you wear it.
What is this bitch singing about?
I don't fucking know. I think she's asking.
Dude, we can't say that. We're a feminist podcast.
What if God was one of us? I don't know. Is that what she's saying?
You jerk. That's Joan Osborne. Can I tell you, I dig Joan Osborne.
Oh, yeah. Down.
Yeah, she's got some legit fucking jams.
We're a feminist podcast. I was almost about to bring up her teeth. I was going to bring up her teeth.
Her teeth?
Jewel's teeth were founding back in the day. And it's not an indictment on her talent. Great artist. Just her
Why
teeth.
Do you need to even talk about her appearance?
That's what I'm saying.
She's an artist, Jerry. She's not a fucking piece of meat for you to judge on her appearance. Is she pretty enough for me? Are her teeth straight enough for me? Is she sexy enough?
Let's talk about that.
Oh, smile, honey. You're disgusting, Jerry.
I hope I'm not.
You're disgusting.
I really need you to do all that shit to an empty chair.
I apologize for Jerry, by the way. I do not agree with his misogynistic ways.
Just look at the teeth. It's real as real.
She got big knockers, though.
Well, there you go.
Doesn't she?
Yeah.
She always had those big knockers.
Go. I mean, what the fuck did you just yell about?
You're a dick, Jerry. You're over here talking shit about women. It's not cool.
Your big knockers.
Oh, see, look.
What's going on? Am I not there?
No, yeah, but look, sometimes that red light's going on.
I don't know what's going on. Maybe am I running out of batteries?
No, there are no batteries.
Are you losing batteries here?
Don't touch anything. It's probably you fucking fiddling with shit.
No, it's not. There's nothing there.
Fiddling. For any of this, because I don't care right now. Hey, so in 1994, the band Pantera released a fucking crushingly heavy album, Far Beyond Driven.
It lost a poll, unfortunately.
An incredible album. And so, because we weren't going to be doing the album on the show, I had to include a song from it here. And to put one of those crushingly heavy songs on this playlist, frankly, would have harshed on my chill.
Yeah, I couldn't listen.
So luckily, at the end of that album,
is this?
They had this cover of Black Sabbath's
Planet Caravan.
And we had talked about it earlier. I believe this is a superior version. I enjoy this version.
Here it is.
I enjoy this version more than the Black Sabbath.
Really? Mm-hmm. Well, that's crazy.
I do,
but...
Maybe I liked it more because of what Phil Anselmo was. Like, this didn't, you know?
Right. I love that they did this and that they did it this way.
And they did it at the end of the album, I believe, right? The way
well,
they, the
actually,
actor,
no? The song was recorded for a Black Sabbath tribute album called Nativity in Black.
I remember that album.
Yeah, Typo Negative was on it, Faith No More, quite a few bands. It was recorded for that. And for some reason, some red tape record label bullshit, it wasn't included on that album. So they had the song, and they just figured, let's put it out. We've got a record coming out. And they even made a note on the album just saying, I was always upset that they had this note, just sort of a trigger warning to fans, letting them know, like, this does not represent a change in our musical direction or anything. We just love Black Sabbath. We love this song, and we thought it would be cool to do.
Why would they put a disclaimer?
They didn't, because they didn't want Pantera fans to yell "sell out." They're not fucking being heavy, like
you
idiots
have
do.
You shouldn't be so subservient to your fan base. You can count on me not doing that, despite my nude pictures that I put on the internet.
Yeah,
to make for your approval. Not you, Joseph. For not the me. People.
Fine,
what are you looking for?
Looking for something.
Right. The disclaimer?
No. The best, one of the coolest things I heard this year, you remember the astronauts Bob and Doug? Mm-hmm. They, I feel like I've told this story already on the podcast, but when they went up there, when they were in orbit, you know, just literally floating through fucking space in a spaceship, they listened to Planet Caravan.
It's appropriate.
Which is, honestly, that's like my dream for my life. Right. Like, well, that's all I've really ever really wanted to do.
I mean, you're in space in this.
If I could be
big
in
blue
space
orb down there,
listening to fucking Planet Caravan, which, believe me, would be on my short space playlist. Believe me, it would be on there.
Space playlist. I have to make one of those. I don't
yeah,
have
you should. Think about it. You get as high as you can. Close your fucking eyes and you think about what songs you want to listen to while you're floating through space.
Oh, that's going to put you in a mind spot. Yeah. I think I want everyone to do that. Everyone
yeah, guys, I would like
send
you to send me in your space stoner fucking playlist.
Now send your space jams.
Space jams. Now, just for the hell of it, Jerry. Just
we are now at 1 hour.
For the hell of it. I don't give a fuck. It's a Nightbird. Let's just listen to Planet Caravan one more time.
We just did it.
But let's listen to Black Sabbath do it back in 1970.
All right.
All right? Just walk. Oh, listen to that.
You think, man, it takes millions of dollars to send someone in space. And the thing that made it, not the fact that they're in space. I'm sure they marvel at it. But they played this, and it came back. And
listen to Ozzy's vocal.
A lot of effects here.
He's actually just singing through a Leslie speaker.
What's a Leslie speaker?
It's like a rotating speaker. It's used on for like organs. You can use it in a lot of different ways. And he's kind of singing through one of those. And that's what that sort of wobble.
Underwater.
Yeah. And this was a song, the lyrics written by Geezer Butler, as most of them were. Just about kind of floating through space, you know?
Bongos.
Just.
Is there a lot of bongo work in Black Sabbath?
No.
This is a rarity for them. They could be moody like this, though.
Oh, yeah.
They weren't slaves to their genre.
Hey, guys, we're slightly breaking format here because who gives a fuck, okay? This song came out in 1970. Sue me. It's not grunge either.
It was only short 24 years later, though.
Yeah.
Short 24, huh?
Kind of.
Sort of a blink in the music industry.
So this is, of course, from Black Sabbath's second album, Paranoid.
I think everyone's owned Paranoid once.
They should.
Cassette, CD, 8-track.
If you haven't owned it yet, please, please, go get a copy. I would give just about anything to actually float in outer space and listen to this song and then die.
Well, that's not what you do.
That's really what I want.
You just
want
to...
No joke,
perish,
Jerry.
Perish.
No joke.
We've talked
no
about
joke.
This.
If I had... If someone came to me right now, our Lord above, if he came to me and said, Joseph, you've spent your years a sinner. And despite all of that, despite your words and your skepticism and your hedonistic behavior and blasphemy,
despite all of that,
right now I'm going to give you the option. You leave it all behind. You leave your entire life, your loved ones, your earthly pleasures and conveniences. And I will send you now in a suitable spacecraft. You will orbit your planet of Earth, and you can listen to any music you want, and you can have as much weed and mushrooms as you want. And
space
then,
mushrooms.
And then when your playlist has ended, you will float away from that spacecraft out into the infinite depths of frozen space, and you will perish. Life no more. Would you take that option? Jerry, I would take it. I would take it.
It's beautiful. It's nice, but leave the passwords for all this shit so I can operate it when you do it.
I'll try to write down a password for you.
Holding off God. Hold on one second. God. Let me just write these passwords down. The grunge must live.
This fucker's gone, but the grunge lives on.
Sally Forth grunge. We will avenge you, Joseph Ruth.
Thank you.
It's a beautiful story, though. I didn't want to interrupt.
That's all right.
Just leave the password. Especially to the PayPal.
Hey, guys. Okay.
Great playlist. Hey. Well done. Very well done.
That was The Nightbird for the year 1994.
Covered a ton of subjects.
And a little bonus thrown in there.
A lot.
Why not?
A lot was discovered tonight.
Yeah. Well, let's recap. We listened to
Nate Dogg.
Several great genres of music.
Beautiful.
Got a little touch of hip hop in there with the Beastie Boys and everything.
Well done, though.
Yeah.
I approve of every song.
Yeah.
We talked about
your sex business.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it was very important. Very nice that we addressed that every show.
We
may have some technical difficulties because we don't understand the light.
I think we're probably fine.
All right.
I want to hope we're fine.
There's going to be moments where my mic was about to self-destruct. That's what it is. But thank you again for listening to that whole thing.
Thanks, guys.
It was wonderful.
If you would take a moment to share the podcast online on your Facebook or whatever you got, Instagram.
And leave a 5-star review.
Please.
Everywhere.
5-star review on the Apple Podcasts.
Spotify. Thing. Google. I don't think Google lets reviews.
I don't care. Just do it on Apple. That's the only one anybody really cares about.
That's not true.
And drop us an email or a selfie or whatever you want. You know, hopefully you guys are all listening to this episode in your underpants.
Tonight was the most appropriate version of that. Like if there was, we were very positive, nice to each other. We talked about some sexual things. We talked about some good music.
Yeah.
This is the one that you want to be naked for.
Right.
I hope you were naked the whole time. And if you weren't...
That's a little weird now. Jerry.
Run it back and then get
just
nude.
To be clear, guys, that's Jerry.
Get nude. I don't care not where me. You're at. Get nude and sit and listen to it again. So three
all right.
hours
Christian
of
Carrillo, Mark Morton, Bill Stowers.
All of you.
All you guys. Underpants. Underpants picks.
No, wait.
Okay, hey guys, before good night.
Good night.
Good night, everybody. Don't be a square.